Alrighty, hello and welcome to Fallout 2.
Give
more copyright claims,
a kiss,
huh?
To build a dream on. In my imagination, we'll drive upon that kiss.
What's this all about now?
I ask no more than this.
Deliver the goods? U.S. Army.
Give me a kiss before you leave me. In my imagination, feed my heart.
Leaving the vault.
Leave me one thing.
Be sure to remember that these basic rules.
A kiss to build a dream on.
Rule number one. Line up in an orderly fashion to be shot by the external raiders. Oh, that was 3D. Weird. Rule number two. Use protective eyewear. So that when you're shot, the blood doesn't get in your eyes. So you can at least see. Years of living in the vault can make the eyes sensitive to natural sunlight. I don't know what to think about this 3D vault boy. Without protective eyewear, extreme something can occur. Oh no, his eyes! They've burned out of their sockets. Once outside the vault, be prepared to live life anew with help from Garden of Eden Creation Kit. Wow. Or Gek. The Garden of Eden Creation Kit. Use the Gek to create the new world you've been waiting for. Wow. Results may vary. The end. Well, it's not the end of the Garden of Eden Creation Kit, though. That's just a new beginning, right? And my avatar does the blush animation way too much. But I have something to work on. Whoa. Oh boy. What's happening here? Beep beep. Oh, hi. Hi there, bud. Oh, wow, look at that happy family with the children. Okay, geez, man. Chill. Someone woke up on the wrong side of the bed today.
War.
Anyway.
War never changes. The end of the world occurred pretty much as we had predicted. Too many humans, not enough space or resources to go around.
I thought you were going to bring up all the anime.
The reasons, as always,
we drowned in anime.
Human
people couldn't live normal lives due to the anime.
The earth was nearly wiped clean of life. A great cleansing. An atomic spark struck by human hands. Quickly raged out of control.
As it would.
Spears of nuclear fire rained from
the skies. Cover under the desk. I learned that. It saves you from nukes. When you're underneath your school desk, you'll be immune to nuclear.
Humanity was almost extinguished. Their spirits becoming part of the background radiation that blanketed the earth.
Oh, that sounds warm and comfy.
A quiet
blanket.
Darkness fell across the planet, lasting many years.
Like, how
few
many?
Survived the
four?
Devastation.
That's
some
a long time, right?
To reach safety,
4 years. I can't even remember
great
4 years back.
Vaults. When the great darkness passed, these vaults opened, and their inhabitants emerged to begin their lives again.
In the open
one of the
world.
Northern tribes claims they are descended from one such vault. They hold that their founder and ancestor, one known as the Vault Dweller, once saved the world from a great evil.
Yep, his name was the Master. I was
According
there.
According to their legend, this evil arose in the far south. It corrupted all it touched, twisting men inside, turning them into beasts.
That was a lieutenant. I
Only
never actually fought him because
Vault
I just blew up his base around
destroyed.
Him.
But in so doing, he lost many of his friends and suffered greatly, sacrificing much of himself to save the world. When at last he returned to the home he had fought so hard
you
to
keep
protect,
saying he, it was Natalia,
he was
she.
Cast out.
Jeez.
Exiled. In confronting that which they feared, he had become something else in their eyes, and no longer their champion. Forsaken by his people, he strode into the wasteland.
Now we'll just pretend
he traveled
that
far
this is all
to the north, until he came to the Great Canyons. There he founded a small village, Arroyo, where he lived out the rest of his years.
Arroyo.
For a generation since its founding, Arroyo has lived in peace, its canyons sheltering it from the outside world. It is home. Your home.
My home?
But the scars home left for by me? The war have not yet healed, and the earth has not forgotten.
Yeah, you ask me, the earth has a pretty good memory. Whoa! Whoa, buddy. This is all stretch it out. What's going on here? I'm gonna turn that on. I looked up what this was. That's why I went to it immediately. I went into this menu. I skipped the cutscenes, so I didn't watch them. I just wanted to get to the menu to, like, mess with the settings a little bit. So I, like, moved this. But I have, like, a little more I want to do. Options. Is there, like, another... Is there, like, a video options thing? No? Okay. We're going new game. I don't like the way you're looking at me, bud. Narg? Narg's story. Narg's exceptional physique has made him one of the best hunters in the tribe. Narg's first and usually only impulse is to crush anything that he can't figure out. Which, is a lot of things. Narg has become quite adept at crushing and slicing and dicing. Those are three very good things to be good at, by golly. Narg would like to prove his worthiness to lead the tribe, and he'll let nothing stand in his way. Well, let's see what our other options are. Mingan? Mingan's whisper, soft tread, and acquisitive fingers. Acquisitive. I don't think I've ever seen that word used in a sentence. Have always aided his natural curiosity. Several years ago, the tribe decided that Mingan's talents would be best used on someone else. Since then, Mingan has been the tribe's most accomplished scout. However, the tents of nearby tribes provide little challenge these days. It's time to scout further afield. Maybe find some deathclaws. Chitza. I don't like that word. Chitza's story. Chitza has always been able to convince others to do things her way. Her winning personality and stunning good looks have often caused others to underestimate the tribe's best... don't get me wrong. If your name is Chitza, I have nothing against you or your name. I just don't like saying it. There's something about it that's just like, Chitza. It sounds like it's a chip that's like made by the least liked company in the world. I'm sorry, I'm digging myself a greater hole. Do not worry about if your name is Chitza. It's fine. Everything's fine. In the course of her frequent journeys, Chitza has learned to deal with the perils of traveling the wastes. Now the tribe needs help and new paths beckon to Chitza. Is that all of them? Yeah, I don't like looking at Narg. I don't really like any, create character. Okay, we'll be male this time, just because. Age, we'll be like, well, I think I'm 27, I think. You know, if we do the math, 27, I think, is the age that I come out, well, soon. When August comes around, then I'll be 27, but I'll just put 27, just because. Okay, so what do I want to be? Well, if it's like the other game, I can get, okay, so I know a little bit about, like, advanced power armor being in this game. It's on the cover. I know lore of Fallout. Advanced power armor's in this game, and it raises strength by 4, and I think I can get +1 somewhere else? So that, leaving this at 5 makes a lot of sense. Agility, we want that up at 9, yes. And we also want luck up. Let's see. Well, Gifted ended up being, like, the best thing ever made by anyone on this whole planet. So we'll go ahead and go for that. And now we have 2 points to put what? Right stuff. I'm trying to do this. Become quite jealous. Well, I mean... Hold on. Is there another one? One-hander, small frame. Can't carry as much. This kind of was a problem in the first game. Not, like, a ton. But also +1 agility would be nice. Cause more critical hits. I feel like I should go for a crit build. Just kind of invest fully in crits. So with single-handed weapons, two-handed weapons cause a problem. I guess that's the other one? Heavy-handed? No, don't want that. And I don't want to go fast shot this time around. You know, I'm tempted to just go with this, just cause, but I don't want to mess with things too much. Yeah, I'll just go finesse, you know? I don't do as much damage, but I cause more critical hits. And I'll raise my luck up to make my crits, like, really... Oh, wait. That's 10%! Wow! That's a decent amount, let me tell ya. If I aim for the eyes, that's gonna be like a crit every time, eh? Okay, so, I'll go similar to the older one, because I do want to just, like, do combat generally. So I'll go into intelligence at the cost of charisma here. Endurance, perception, these are both good. Strength, I'll leave at 5. This looks like a good starter stat lineup here. So, yeah, for my skills. So... In the last game, everybody's like, oh, don't go energy weapons, that's a late game option. But you could get energy weapons actually really fast. And, like, it wasn't that big of an issue. And energy weapons are like the strongest guns in the game. That said, I did say I wanted to do a big guns build. So miniguns, rocket launchers, flamethrowers. I think I'm going to go big guns with melee weapons up until I get to that point. Maybe unarmed? Unarmed naturally is higher percentage just at base, but melee weapons, I imagine, would... I think you start with a spear, so I think I'm just gonna go with melee weapons. As for what else, if books are as plentiful as in the first game, I imagine repair and science and all that are gonna be easy to rank up with alongside outdoorsmen. So, probably lockpick would be a really good one to choose, I imagine. See, now I know about this game, and I know, like, what the good skills are since I played through the first one. See, I'm gonna go with lockpick, melee weapons, and big guns. And everything else I can probably learn through books, or I don't really need. Barter would probably be good. You know what? No. Instead of lockpick, I'm gonna go barter, just so I can get more stuff. No. Yeah, I'm going lockpick. Okay, I think I'm good. Good, done. Wait, you haven't changed your player name. No, hold on. I don't want to be named Nun. I'm going to be called, let's see, what's a good name for this man? He's very lucky, very agile. He will be very strong. He's also a smart cookie. I'm thinking, Jimbin. His name is Jimbin. Okay, let's go, Jimbin.
Come in, chosen one.
Whoa.
There are things you must know.
Okay, is it about what's in that giant, signs are everywhere. Thing?
Withering crops.
That's a dying withered crop. Brahmin. That Brahmin is dying. It's taking a long time to die.
Sick children.
Those don't look like children, friend. Are you sure those aren't goblins from the Outer Realm?
A slim hope that few know of.
Yeah?
The old discs speak of an item called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. It is said it can bring life to the wasteland.
Well, we're alive, aren't we? Aren't we life in the wasteland? Gimme. Come into the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. I'll make a thing.
Will be your quest if you prove yourself worthy.
I'll do it. I'll prove myself.
For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials.
I will eat everyone there.
If you survive, come back to me. We will talk more. Our life is in your hands, chosen one.
Okay.
Prove yourself. Find the Gek. Be our salvation.
I'll salvate you. Do not you worry even one little bit. Alrighty, here I am. Wow. So instead of a vault thing, ooh, this interface looks different. I have a spear. I'll put that on my thing. Okay, hello, friend. Clint, a fellow tribesman. Greetings, chosen one. It is good to see you. How may I serve you? Just thought I'd say hello. I'll be leaving on my quest soon. May the spirits of our ancestors protect you, chosen one. I wish you well in your journey. Barter? Will you give me things? Can I? No. Okay, well. Off on my journey to the temple to eat all of its inhabitants whole. A pole with human skulls attached. That's grotesque. Do I just go? Do I just leave? Can I? Can I just be on my? Do I go in here? You're in a dark, misty temple. The shadows seem to play tricks with your eyes, and you can hear the faint sound of movement. Could it perhaps be these giant ants? Alrighty, let's see if we can. Oh, they initiated combat. But unfortunately, a little bit too far. Let's see. I'm out of range. Oh no. Stab it. I missed. Okay. Oh. Looks like I would have been able to slash again, but nope. Come at me. Waste all your action points. Yes, now I can stab you times two. Okay, well. Except for two hit points. Amazing. Can I just stab an ant? It's a giant ant right in front of me. Just let me stab it, dude. Okay, I gained 25 XP. These are... He looks dead. Wow, thanks for the help. Very descriptive. Very helpful. What's in here? Stone bench. Stone bench. Okay, there's just a bunch of benches in the wall. Who put those dang old benches there? Come at me, ant! I think I only need to get here for the spear? I think? Either way. I think I'm gonna end my turn here. So that I can stab twice. Hit for five, and it dead. Yes, I am a master at killing ants. There's nobody greater at me than killing ants. Can I loot them? No. I guess it doesn't let you loot them if they don't have anything on them, which is kind of nice, actually. Okay, we'll go through this door, and then we will ignore all of the famous songs that occur as a result of doing this. Okay, let's just save our game. Jimbin. Yes. Game saved. What is all this? Is there anything of note in here, or is this just a bunch of stone benches and incense burners? There are walls? That's neat. I've never seen those before. So where do I go here? There's a thing over there, there's a place up there, and this looks like a dead end. Wait. A pot. Perhaps I could loot the pot. But I think I saw a ant in there. Oh, there's one. So just end turn, because it initiated, and I have greater sequence than it, I can do that. Cool. Alrighty, and then I'll let these guys initiate. Because my sequence is so good. Come at me, come on, man. Yes, I will stab the ant. And then I end turn. Oh, that one's coming at me now. Well, let me stab that one. That one is dead. Stab that one, and then I can take one step back. You missed! How inept. Inept, I say. What's in the pot? A healing powder. Okay, I'll take it. Why not? What's this? It's just a floor depression. Oh, that's unfortunate. I hope it gets over it soon. Okay, let's move over up here. No, I'm such a burpy boy. I do many burps. As it turns out, I don't even need anyone to pat my back and call me a little infant. I burp on my own. Because I'm a grown-up. Is that a scorpion? That's a red scorpion. Wow, that was painfully slow. There are red scorpions in here. Severely wounded. Well, hopefully this isn't the worst usage of my time. Did I slay it? Dead. Yes. End combat. 60 XP. Okay, let's save, just in case Jimbin falls victim to a big old arachnid man here. Stone bench. Stone bench. What is that? Bones? Are there items on these bones? Do these guys have tails that I can take? Scorpion tail, yes. Okay, I'll take that. Oh, there's a take all now, but... Take all now, but... There's a take all button now, is what I meant to say. Hello? Anybody want to tussle with Jimbun? Any scorpulids want to tussle with Jimbun? Let me save one more time. Save frequently. This is what the first game taught me. And then... Okay, yes. Come at me, friend. Just you, though. Not your other man. The other one is not invited. Okay. Where is my positioning currently? I'm currently in the right spot. So I stay here. This guy's gonna come around. But it's fine. Because I'm going to continue a thrust at the other man. And then I'm gonna stab that one. And then take a step back. Do not poison me. I will cry. Don't miss twice. You missed. Haha. I should be doing called shots. I just realized. Or maybe not. Let me... Hold on. Yeah. Let's see. I'll just do the carapace. There we go. 8 hit points and killed. Done. Take its tail. Are their tails still like 20 pounds? This is what I want to know. This is what I need to know. Yeah, it would appear so. They still weigh like 20 poundos. What's on these bones? Another spear? Okay, I'll take it. Wasn't a plasma rifle, but you know, I'll accept it. You know, this game's being really stingy with the loot. Hasn't even given me a laser gun yet. But you know, sometimes you just gotta deal with what you're given. Appears to be locked. Can I pick that? Lockpick on the door? I definitely pick the lock on the door. I'm so deft. Next area. Save my game. Old Jimbun here. And let's go through this wide open. There's a raised plate. Yeah. There's this giant wide open room here. With tons of traps, I'm sure. I see a raised plate. What do you want me to do about it? Traps? You failed to disarm the trap. Can I just go around it? Okay, well, I think I can see the traps at least. See a raised plate. Yeah, so I can actually see traps. Interesting. Don't walk into it, please. Okay, so that's good. At least I can see where traps are now. I don't think I could see them before. Where is the other raised plate? Oh, there's a scorpion. Is this close enough to... Thrust to the scorpion? Carapus. And then, if I end turn... I'm just gonna do regular thrust. Because I can't aim very good yet. Okay, 60 XP for that. Save game. Now I'm through the trap room. Jimbun's gonna be the greatest warrior of all time. You'll see. Come at me, fiend! There, and then stab it. Woo. I don't have enough action points, so I'll end my turn, and I'll just stab it. And was killed. Okay, combat done. There's a chest right there. Does it have power armor? A plasma rifle? No, just some healing powder. Disappointing. Anything else in here? Anything that I need? No? But it's just a wall? That's a crack in the ground. That's not a wall. You silly bean. You silly weirdo. A raised plate. Wait. Was that back there? Or was that up here? I was going to call it an apple. That's not an apple. It's an ant. An apple is a slightly different organism from an ant, I have to say. And I'm not sure why I wanted to say apple. Okay. Can I hit the apple, please? No? Okay. What's gonna miss me, so that's good. Okay, the apple has been slain. We can end combat and take whatever's in this pot. Plastic explosives. Okay, we'll take it. So a giant ant and another door. There's another giant ant there, but there's a chest back there. Maybe that one has the plasma rifle in it. I bet. You know what? If I were a betting man, I'd bet all the money in my entire bank account on that having a plasma rifle. No, I wouldn't. Do not attempt. So I need to get probably to here so that I can stab a man. Okay, well, let me end my turn and try this again. Can I, like, stab successfully for once in my entire life? Could I just stab successfully? All I ask is that I stab successfully. I took melee weapons as a skill. At least he's missing too. But like, 53% chance, man. Out of like 7 hits so far, 1 is hit. Jeez, that was a very agile creature. I think I need to use some healing powder. Okay. Healed for 10, that's good. And then I can zip on this way, skip that other ant, and then... Oh, there's another one down there. What? Hold on, that doesn't... let's move one. I guess, yeah, it is an ant, just weird. Okay, I killed it. Neat. Now you approach me. And that is 2 away. Okay, so I'll move 1. And I will stab twice. Come on. Aye. So it begins. There we go. Okay. And combat. What's in this chest? A gun? Antidote. Okay. Well, I'm not poisoned, I don't think. No, not poisoned. Alrighty, now I can slay this final being here with our full potential. Yeah, come at me. And then I stab. Stab. Turn. And stab. Stab. There we go. Okay, that one was much better. What's in here? Open the door. What's in the box? Jimbin. Impenetrable door. It is not penetrable. Well, let's save and let's try a few things here. Such as lockpick? No. Impenetrable door. Well, Pip, you aren't wearing the Pip Boy. I don't have a Pip-Boy yet. I can't do it, even though this inventory is kind of like using a Pip-Boy. Don't worry about it. So what do I do here? Is there a... I see like a thingy down here. Does this lead anywhere? Where am I? Where am I going? Where did I come from? Where do I go? So that just kind of loops around the thingy, eh? Chasm. Well, there's an impenetrable door that way. There's a room full of traps this way. So what do I do? Where do I go and what do I do? Nothing on this wall. So I use the a lit torch and a wall sconce. Torch. What possibly would allow me through here? Look at it. We're destroyed with a well-placed explosive. You've given me an idea. Okay. Done. There was conveniently a plastic explosive in the other one that was there. That I can use. Set the timer to 20 seconds and don't immediately explode. Okay, I think I'm far enough away now. If you explode, that would destroy the door, yes? Yes! Cool. Detonates prematurely, that's fine. This is actually the outcome I expected. Trigger the trap and narrowly avoid the projectile shot from the wall. Ooh. Okay, there's an ant all the way over there. Oh. It gets my thingy. I can't, like, see where it is. Okay, so I can move, like, there. Can I hit it from here? Yes. And then I can end turn and still be first on prowl here, so I can attack another two times. And then go back one. Do not hurt me. I only want to stab you to death. So there's another ant up there, and this leads over to... There's a chest all the way down here. There's a scorpion. Okay, well, let's see if we can combat with this ant here. You want to brawl, bud? You want to brawl? Okay, I can't hit it just yet. I think this is still one space too far. Yeah, so let's move one closer. And then I can do that, and then turn. There we go. Okay, and combat. Save. Frequently save. Jimbun. There is a chest over there, but there are also chests over here. R, one single chest. This is proper usage of word. Wall. Come at me, scorpion. You won't. Is that close enough? No. Move one closer. And then I can stab it. And then turn. And then stab it twice. Yes. Okay, there's one more scorpion down there. What do you want? What do you want, bucko? Bub. So that's the space it's on. I'll go to three. So I get one stab. And then, wow, I hit it pretty hard. Turn, and hopefully I get it within these next two stabs. Yep. Cool. Combat. Take this. Those are going to weigh me down quite a bit, I can tell. What's in this chest? Some antidote and healing powder. Okay. And then on this guy is going to be another tail. Because they all have tails, as it turns out. I should probably just hit that take all button just to get into the habit of it. But meh. Okay, well. What's in this here? Nothing. I'll take all. Done. Metal door. Can I utilize this metal door to open? Yes. Okay, well. Any traps? Any traps waiting for me here? Oh, there's a dude. Hmm. Cameron, a fellow tribesman. Well, I guess we'll talk to him in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed this one. We're going to be playing through Fallout 2 and then moving on to the other games. But first, Fallout 2, and I'm going to play this through all to the end and do as much as I can. So, yeah, see you in the next one. Bye-bye.